One of the most common questions we get asked is the key difference between THC and CBD. Both are molecules found in cannabis and hemp plants, and are just two of over 100 other compounds called cannabinoids that all serve different functions within the body. We'll dive deeper into specific cannabinoids in the next episode, but for this video, we're just gonna talk about those two, THC and CBD. They're the ones in the spotlight most often because they've quite literally spent so much time under a microscope being researched by scientists. And that research has pointed to just how compatible both can be with our bodies. Hi, I'm Matt with Lazarus Naturals. And today, we're gonna be discussing THC and CBD. As we discussed in the first video, our body's endocannabinoid system, or ECS, is a network of receptors found throughout our central nervous system, as well as every other part of our body. Essentially, its job is to tell some key background processes what to do to help keep us balanced, or homeostatic. You know, things like mood, immune system function, body temperature, sleep-wake cycles, appetite, and pain responses, all of which help us feel and be our best. But in order for this system to accomplish its mission, it depends on chemical messengers in the form of endocannabinoids. Endo meaning within, produced naturally by our bodies. These are released by our body when things need to get moving and bind to cannabinoid receptors to help inform our bodies what to do. One example is anandamide, a neurotransmitter released when we go through rigorous exercise. Known as the bliss molecule, it was named after the Sanskrit word ananda, meaning supreme joy. Our bodies use it to keep our mental state in check while they're dealing with stress. THC bonds to that same receptor, and this is where cannabinoids like CBD and THC really come into play. THC is a phytocannabinoid, phyto meaning plants, that is a lot like anandamide. This is part of the reason that an influx of THC causes you to feel euphoric or blissful. Both THC and CBD can bind to our endocannabinoid receptors and mimic our natural endocannabinoids, allowing them to work with the ECS in order to get things done, but in different ways. You may have already guessed the primary difference between THC and CBD, which is that THC will get you high and CBD will not. THC is considered psychoactive, meaning that it affects the mind. Although from a technical standpoint, it's worth pointing out that CBD is also considered psychoactive as it affects your mental state. So a better distinction would be that CBD differs from THC in that it is non-intoxicating. However, you'll still frequently see on the internet non-psychoactive mentioned in reference to CBD. Now you know. Throughout your ECS, you have two primary sets of endocannabinoid receptors, CB1 and CB2. Our CB1 receptors are mainly in our brain, as well as throughout our central nervous system, whereas CB2 receptors are mostly found in the immune system. THC binds to both sets of receptors. The high from THC originates from its interaction with your CB1 receptor. However, CBD doesn't really have an affinity for either, which is why it doesn't cause you to feel that same intoxication. Some scientists believe that CBD might bind to a receptor we haven't even discovered yet. Even without the high that THC produces, you can still tell that CBD is there. The stimulation of the ECS helps promote more balanced moods, which may in turn promote better sleep. Maybe even more importantly, it helps to reduce the ability of the body to signal pain or anxiety responses. THC, however, does bind to both receptors, and because of the high that comes with it, it affects your perception. So THC may make you feel euphoric or pain-free, even though your ECS is still releasing signals of inflammation and pain. Its mind-altering effects are extremely helpful when chronic pain causes a lack of appetite or difficulty sleeping. You know what they say, mind over matter. And that's an important distinction. THC has a host of therapeutic properties thanks to these mind-altering effects, whereas CBD's benefits stem mainly from its effects within the ECS and the background processes it helps to encourage. But how did these two compounds come to light, and which came first? CBD was unknowingly first discovered way back in 1940 by a British chemist named Robert S. Kahn. In his research, he mistook a partial CBD molecule for CBN. 2 years later, chemist Roger Adams was able to isolate CBD, making it the first isolated cannabinoid. His studies led to the later discovery of the individual cannabinoid THC by Israeli chemist Dr. Rafael Meshulam. It was Meshulam who identified and named anandamide in the early 90s. Despite numerous studies in the last 60 years identifying positive impacts of CBD, especially for those dealing with epilepsy, the potential for research lost a lot of momentum when cannabis was made a Schedule I drug in 1971. That, coupled with the stigma of cannabis and cannabis users pushed by the federal government and law enforcement, set the potential for scientific discovery and understanding of CBD and our ECS decades behind where it could be today. But with cannabis legal in so many states now, the capacity for large-scale CBD research is growing rapidly. The same goes for THC. It is very quickly becoming evident the major roles both cannabinoids are playing in improving the lives of people across the world. That's it for us in this second installment of our educational CBD 101 series. Check out the links below for more education and tips. And as always, thanks for watching.